This podcast would probably sound better if I recorded it on the computer. But I'm not going to because yesterday I was trying to do this specific podcast. Then I did another and out of anger, and I'm so glad I didn't post it. Because I woke up with a whole different perspective on the subject. It doesn't matter whether I like that guy or not. You know, I was watching everybody panic about the Hollywood ritual and that little gay guy that, whatever his name is, Smith. Whether he's talented or not is irrelevant. And this is, I'm going to give you all an honest, this is around the anniversary in 1997 that this happened. Because I ordered the Marilyn Manson albums probably about 2 or 3 weeks before they came in. They came in about the end of January and the 1st of February. And somewhere between that, this happened because I had just got them in the mail. And while I was waiting on him, I started hearing and seeing all these things about how satanic he was. And about his connections with Anton LaVey, and I thought, well, y'all people are seeming like y'all are condemning him, but he's young, I mean. And I was a young Christian, and I was still into my rock and roll, still am. I'm not going to let these devils run me off from rock and roll. God created music. And you can style things for good or bad. I don't always use mine for good. Sometimes I use mine to get back at people that says things about me, which is something I learned from Axl Rose and people like that. But you can use music for good or bad. You could go in there and make a whole album that was positive, and you could style it as hard and grungy or as devilish as you wanted, and it would still be good. It would still have a good meaning because its message would be good. I'm going to post this over on Podomatic as an audio file. But I'm going to roll the intros. Then I'm going to come back on the other side, and I'm going to try to do this thing from a godly perspective and a spiritual perspective as far to how I was dealing with it the other day, because I was getting frustrated. Do you realize that Jesus controls even these things? But I woke up to something this morning, and I posted it on Facebook just a few minutes ago. Now we're going to go into it for the podcast. It's like I said, I am so glad. Yesterday I was ranting. I mean, I thought somebody was stopping me from saying, but it was from an earthly point of view. This is the spiritual point of view here. And I'm going to turn this around. I'm going to make the prayer bigger. Because there's a lot of captives in rock and roll that need to be set free. And God says, let my people go. And they're still his people. They may be lost, but they're still his people. Let my people go, Satan. I'm making the prayer bigger. You can't spook me. You showed me five or six around me just like Hellraiser. I couldn't draw that portal too well. I couldn't even draw them too well, but I didn't see them too well anyway. But I woke up to an album cover that, with the exception of the black eyes and the color, it even has things on its head and even has hair hanging down. But I seen it with my glasses. I didn't see them with the glasses. But I kid you not, I drew them last night for the podcast. And I even got the screenshot on my Guns N' Roses karaoke videos. But I woke up to that album cover this morning. Here we go. We're going to just roll the intro and get this podcast started.
Trigger warning. This podcast may contain language that may offend some. Listener discretion is advised. The views expressed are mine and mine alone and do not represent the host of this show. From the former United States, now known as Occupied FEMA Region 4, you are listening to APfnS Live. Now here is your host, Anthony Stone.
I'll cut this intro short just a bit just to debut my new podcast. You know, the one I made for Rock and Roll 100, it's going to be covering headlines. Here's the headlines one, and I'm going to shut up and I'm going to just go right to it. I wanted y'all to hear it as well because I haven't recorded a podcast with it yet. So here we're going to debut it right now.
Welcome to Rock and Roll 100 FM's Headline Blitz Podcast with your host, Anthony Stone.
Now, 1997 was sort of a darker year for me. I was watching The Crow all the time. I had a dark period in my life in the late 90s, and particularly 96, 97, 98, 99. Those were bad years because I'd realized that I was disabled. I actually started realizing that I was really disabled, not just sick as a kid, you know. And those were dark years, and I was even gravitating towards dark stuff, like even Marilyn Manson. But now the thing about this, I didn't know how dark he was. I just thought it was, you know, just like Alice Cooper, a show. And I still believe it. But now what was happening was back in this very time, 1997, which that ceremony runs in par with it that happened the other day with the gay guy. It's actually running around in history, repeating itself, about this demonic attack. And I was watching people reacting in fear of it. I'm thinking, you don't have to pray these things. Even they have to listen to the name of Jesus. So fear not that the Lord is with you. Now, I fear for the ones that aren't saved. And I fear for the ones that they are putting a spell around. And that's why I'm glad that I didn't post that podcast yesterday. Because if I'd posted that, I'm thinking it was God that intervened. But I'm telling you, I think I found it last night. But I browsed and I browsed and I browsed and I couldn't find that thing. But I think it was the Lord that hid that thing for me. Because I did pray for him to meet when I was actually ranting about it. And I was praying. I prayed for him to let me say the right things. And you know me, I get worldly. I mean, I got a good video game that I can tell y'all to look at. It's the Soul Reaver 2, where he's in a natural world, but he goes into another world. That's sort of me. But because I've seen the video game, I realize that there's another world. But yet when I'm in the natural, and every day I probably am in the natural, I think of things from a natural point of view. Not the spiritual. I'm thinking of the spiritual this morning. The spiritual, because I woke up to that image after trying to attempt to draw these things. This is a better drawing than mine, with the exception of the missing black eyes. It even has things on its head. Its color is brown. It's not black like the podcast is black. I mean, the ones that I've seen were black. I'm sorry that banging was disrupting me. It's not that these things were black, and the portal was like a clear portal. I can describe you a drawing more dramatized version is the He-Man. When they'd open and they were huge. These were just around the bends. And they were clear. They were like clear ripples. And they appeared and the fingers came first. And I seen the fingers for a long time. I'm going to put all these pictures in the video. I'm going to put the album covers of the albums they came in. I'm going to put him in there, the little Sam Smith or whatever his name is there, with his Satanic Ritual. And then I'm going to put the pictures of my things, which I've shared on and the album cover that I seen this morning. I don't know who this band is, but whoever their art director was had that thing down, with the exception of the eyes and the color. But you know, maybe there's different forms of these things. But it's similar, and it's a huge thing, because you can see little men walking away with their souls in the bottom. So it's big. It's overtowering these things. Maybe that's Satan. Maybe he wears a different color. And this little henchman wears black. Who knows? Maybe they all look the same. And even he looks like them. It's just he might be bigger than them. Who knows? They got this thing, and he's on the cover, and he's got the big fingers. And I thought, whoa, that's it. It even has things on its head. Now, I couldn't see the things in detail. But I could see the fire shooting around them. And Ozzy Osbourne. I'm going to see. Hold on just a second. I want to see if I can't find this demo. And I know copyright doesn't allow, but we're just going to put the clip here. I'm going to go to YouTube right now. I'm going to go to YouTube right now. And we're going to type in Black Sabbath Song Demo. And here's the Iceman Covenant, which is the album I've got. And that's it, but we're going to find the part. I hope I ain't already passed it. He talks about an image too, he sees. Find out I'm the chosen one. I think I done passed it. Stands before me. Five of them stood before me, but I was praying about Marilyn Manson.
What is this that stands before?
What is this that stands? I'm gonna go back. It's with the first of the song. Sorry, y'all. I can't remember. It's a big song. I couldn't remember exactly where it's at. Big and black and points at me.
Turn around quick and scared to run.
You want to know something? I'm going to tell you, I was scared. I screaming bloody murder. My mom and sister heard it. I was 3 days into this prayer, and I don't even know if you could hear that, but it's a it's called Black Sabbath Demo Version, and I am confident that Black Sabbath saw something. And I think what they seen was big and black, and it had fingers. And because those are the entities that you're dealing with when you're dealing with that worship of Hollywood. Now, I was getting frustrated because I'm watching everybody have a panic attack about their rituals and about their magic. But these are lower entities. These things are low. God has your prayers have more power in your little pinky, in your little teeny tiny toe, than these entities. Now, I'm going to have to keep this in contest. I'm so glad they knew who I was, because there's an instance in the Bible where these entities said, Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. You, I do not know. And they tore him apart. But you know what? I did use the name of Jesus. This is what I said. In the name of Jesus, I want you to go back as you came. And the fingers back into the wall and the portal and the fire went back in. And they went back. They had to listen to the name of Jesus. And I know why God let me see that. Because y'all remember, you think back to my tales about God. And my prayer for my mother. As a kid, as a young man who wasn't working, living at home. Right then, I didn't know exactly I was disabled. And I was thinking in my head I was going to eventually have a job, eventually. But back then, I didn't know what I was going to do, because then my father, he wasn't as always kind as my mother was. Indeed, he pretty much believed in if you had to crawl to get up and crawl. That was his philosophy. I never was able to just get up and crawl. That was my daddy. He eventually got to it. He got around to it. I even witnessed him hear it, say it. That he was very hard on disabled people when he was young, but now that he got older and he went blind, he's not getting around as good anymore. He changed his mind on that. I heard him talking to somebody. I don't remember if it's his brother or my sister or some of the others that he would talk to. But I heard him tell that. And he was hard on disabled people. He believed in crawling. I hadn't figured out just yet that I was totally really disabled. And it ain't just something they cooked up. It's real. It's legit. Because I got to the point where I couldn't even hardly walk at all. And I was walking for exercise back then. Started tinkering off around 96 and 97. The walking. I got where I was barely doing the walking for exercise by then, because I was hurting so bad the walking. That's when I started going to doctors, trying to get the disability and everything. And those were tough years. Dark years, too. But I was a young Christian. I'd made that decision in 94. After my mother seen a big, huge entity that was white with a blighted out face. And when she told me she saw the big man and he was muscular, he was built like a wrestler, Billy Ray, I thought back to the man in the fire. And I'd always tell God when I was a kid, show me yourself, Lord. And that particular morning, my mama was having some surgery, and they informed her that she might not come out of it. That's one of the things, that's always a risk. And that spooked the hell out of me at that young age. And I prayed to God and I said, but God, I don't want you to send an angel. You know I don't know whether you're real or not. But if you are real, I don't want you to just send an angel. I want you to go yourself. Well, she saw this big dude right beside her. muscular, and a whited out face, a lighted out, bright light. She said there was a big bright light around his face. Well, they say if you see his face, you burn. That got my attention. So by August 94, this was late 93, end of the year 93, December. So by 94, I was a Christian. But I wasn't, I was still worldly then. I'm probably only a little more advanced than I was then. And I got even more advanced listening to Rodney Howard Brown. So that was good that I ran into him. I'm probably a little more advanced by then, but not much in my Christian walk. Because I can tell you, I'm worldly, childish, rock and rollish. I cuss a lot. And yesterday, that podcast has been from a worldly point of view, and I am so glad that it hit itself, because today is another, waking up to that cover and seeing that thing on the cover with its fingers, and how it looked with its robe and its things in its head and its hair hanging down its behind its arms. It has hair hanging down. It's all brown. The picture's all brown, but this thing was on. But what if it was brown and it just looked black in that dark room? Because my room, I'm going to tell you, the light had burned out. It was one of those old light fixtures that you had to put the long ones in. And instead of having new ones put in, I just used lamps from that time forward. So it was pretty much a lamp-lit room. And you know how lamp-lit rooms are. They're kind of dark and dingy. So maybe these things were right colored. And I just saw them as black because I didn't have my glasses on. I took my glasses off just a second before they appeared. And I think that was Jesus keeping me from having a heart attack. That's really what I believe. Because I'm going to be honest, but I learned something from that. And I've never feared any time I've ever even thought about bowing down to fear in these things. I remember them backing up and doing just what I told them to do. In the name of Jesus. So in the name of Jesus, I curse that little ceremony. I curse that little ceremony they had the other night. But I'm also cursing it for the rock stars that you got under your spell. And I'm not going to name any names this time. You know, it was about Marilyn Manson all those years ago when I'm doing this. And I probably should do it in private. But that was a public ritual, so we're going to do a public prayer. We're going to combat the, and if you agree with me on this in the name of Jesus, because two or more agrees, it shall be done. Do not back down on fear. And I know y'all was alarmed. I already had that realization back then, what I was dealing with. And I even, seeing what goes on with Hollywood and the government, I have put two and two together that the same entities that are over the Hollywood are the same entities. So this is what they appear like, y'all. And you can see them in my podcast right now, and I'm flipping them back and forth as I play this audio clip. I'm going to put me in the podcast too with them behind me, because I used that last night as a screenshot. Because I'd already recorded a podcast yesterday. But I decided not to go with that one. I'm so glad, because it was worldly and I was complaining about that little dude. You know, I may not like him, but somebody loves him. See, he's got some family. Somebody loves him. Maybe some of his fans are loving him. He's got people to care about him. I may not like him and I may not want to hear him. He's got somebody that cares about him. So I'm going to make this prayer to any Hollywood. But y'all know something, I really do believe my prayers worked with that. Because look at, all throughout his career, look at Marilyn Manson, look at the struggles. Hopefully he's coming out. I had a little glimmer of hope because I prayed for Kenya when they kidnapped him. And then he come out of that thing saying that God, he felt God was with him. So whatever reason, even though I'm the way I am, God hears my prayers. I can't tell you why. That's a big mystery to me. I just have to say, thank you, Jesus, because I'm not worthy. Come think of it, none of us were a word. Oh, that's the reason he did what he did. That's the reason he died on the cross. Because none of us are worthy. None of us were worthy. I got choked up here thinking about that. Why did he list the dummy who won't fully wake up and it sees it? He sees it in his face, but yet he stays in the worldly all the time. That's what I'm trying to say. But anyways, my prayers extended to any of the Hollywood. Come, if you want to come out, I bind the devil over you. Any of you artists, I bind that devil. And may you get the truth. Get away. I'm going to tell y'all something else. You people are talented. Some of you. I don't think he is. But he might be. Who knows? I mean, some people might find. You know, we're all. Another man's junk is another man's treasure. And people tells me I'm not worth anything. But yet, I've always did sort of well in charts and things on an independent level. I never got to be the entertainer that I wanted to be, but I wouldn't have sold my soul anyway. So I'd have been like Mark Dice. They would have turned me away. I'd have got up there. They would have wanted me to sign it in blood. And I wouldn't have signed it in blood, and I wouldn't have got signed. Because I'm not selling my soul. Because, of course, I can anyway. And you haven't either. You see, that's the important thing. Whoever I'm talking to, besides my audience, hopefully this gets bigger. Nothing I ever do amounts to anything, but hopefully this one does, because I'm extending that prayer that I prayed for Marilyn Manson all them years to any of you, whether I like you or whether I don't. Because God does love you, whether I like you or not. I'm extending it to all of you. And I, in the name of Jesus, with my prayers, and I hope some of you other people that pray back my prayer, because that makes it all the more powerful. But you don't have to have all that. You see, even your prayer changes the course of history. Just your one prayer. You don't have to have three or more, but you need three or more. You need your fellowship. And with COVID, I've seen that. I used to even was mocking towards that. But there's a reason. I mean, I'd listen to these old hard-nosed people. Well, you're going to go to hell, Frank Church. I'm not sure you're going to go to hell. I think you probably need it. It just depends on whether you're saved or not, is whether you're going to hell or not. You need to probably try your best to be saved and act saved and not be like me and being there. That's what I was crying about while I go, because, boy, isn't it just comforting to know that if he's with somebody like me and you're better than me, he can be with you. That's what I'm trying to say there. Because sometimes I wish I was better, and sometimes I don't care. You know, it's like the song, Don't Down Me. The one that sparked me more than anything when I was becoming a singer. Don't damn me when I speak a piece of mind, because silence is... No, no, Axel, he's just a man. He was the guy that sold rock and roll to me, but he's still just a man. And I've always looked at him that way. There's one time I feared that I turned somebody into a god. And it was Kurt Cobain, but then I realized his life went the way it did because it was going that way. And there was a spiritual battle for him, just like there's a spiritual battle for each and every one of those artists. And ever since then, I've sort of prayed for everybody I listened to. I didn't even know Marilyn Manson that well back then when I bought his albums. I thought, well, if all this stuff is true they're saying about him, somebody needs to pray about that. Instead of just holding signs and irritating the piss out of him, irritating him and pushing him further away from the Lord, somebody needs to take time to care about him, to pray about him. And that was my thoughts. And I did. And I was in the 3 days. I'd be, before I go to bed, I'd pray for certain things. And I'd be, Lord, this stuff they say about Marilyn. And poof, that night, I got ready to go to bed. And something happened. It triggered something. You know, you that little voice, down, 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 Hellraiser. There's no sound. It was just ripples and fire shooting out of ripples and then the fingers and then finally the entities. And I screamed out. I screamed, aah! But both terrible. I was in, you know, I thought I was in the song. I believe you really seen something. I believe that song's real. It's always one of my favorite songs. Even though I started bong, especially around Halloween. Bong! I've always played it on the duck. Since I've had that CD. That's the first time I heard it, by the way, is when I had the CD. When I got the CD. Ozzy, by the way, I'm praying for you too. I know you're crippled right now. I had to make that decision early on. But he was screaming out. I was screaming, and my sister and my mother heard the blood chilling scream. But then it come to me. Every dream I ever had with demons, and I had dreams with demons, and I'd say, in the name of Jesus, go back the way you came, or get away from me. And they always left. So I decided to use it in the real world. And just as they came, they went back. So even they had to obey Jesus. I bind that devil. I bind that ritual. I bind all rituals that are done by Hollywood in the name of Jesus. This is the way you handle it, y'all. You don't handle it with fear. You don't back down with fear. You pray. You be the candle in the darkness. And I'm not good at that, y'all. Indeed, that other podcast was not good at that. I was talking from the worldly because I was getting more irritated with seeing the fear of people fearing them than what was going on. But after waking up to that album cover, it put it in perspective, the Rodney Howard Brown way. The spiritual way, not looking at the natural. I'll see y'all next time. I hope I did pretty good with this podcast. But in the name of Jesus, all your rituals are blinded. And any of the people that want to come out, may you come out in the name of Jesus. And you can't sell your soul. It don't matter if you have written that in kind. Because guess what? God owns the soul. I'm gonna risk and put this on YouTube. It may get taken down. But in the name of Jesus, I bind that devil. I bind the devil big tech. Because I think it needs to be on YouTube. Even though I'm shadow banned. I'm putting it on YouTube. In the name of Jesus, we bind that devil. I want some people to pray with me. I know Rodney. Well, I'm just going to write. I'm going to write that prayer to Rodney. We're going to bind that devil. We're going to bind that national devil, that international devil, that multi-dimensional devil, because they are demons. They are dimensions. I've seen the portals. We're binding that devil. And anybody who wants to come out, may you come out. In the name of Jesus, and the ones that don't, I'm praying that somewhere down the line before you die, you do come out. Even if you reject it up front, even if you reject what I'm saying, come out. Let my people go, God says, Satan. He's telling you to let his children, these people, are. Some of them are talented, some of them have, and their lifestyles and their personalities and their quirks is what led to them being songwriters. And this demon, this songwriter of songwriters is preying on them to not only destroy their lives, but destroy the lives of using the influence of Hollywood to do it. Other people. To influence people wrong. So we bind you, Satan. You're already defeated. You were defeated at the cross. That's what most people don't realize. They talk about past tense, about the power of his kingdoms. He lost all that at the cross in the 3 days in hell with Jesus. When he went down there, Jesus whooped his butt. He don't have those kingdoms anymore. He's holding on to them. But he already lost then. This is going to come to a head. You see, it's timeless. Even though it's been 2,000 years, in God's world, 2,000 years is nothing. So it's really just playing out. You're just really seeing it play out. Satan is holding on with everything he's got, but he done lost. Don't worry about that past tense. He had those kingdoms. He don't since Jesus defeated him in hell and freed the captives in paradise. You know, he had a place called Paradise down there that the saved people were going to. Now they go straight to heaven. Back then they went to paradise. Welcome to paradise. I'll see y'all next time. APfnS is signing out.
You've been listening to the APS Show by Anthony Stone. Thank you. All rights reserved. Rockandroll100fm.com.
You see, they're even losing in today's world. I mean, look, they wanted that COVID thing to be so much worse than it's been. They're losing on every front. That's why they're dragging up balloons and everything else. It's because in nuclear, trying to get nuclear started. I'm praying Jesus stops that. I'm praying Jesus hinders that. Because even these creatures have to obey Jesus. They don't know it yet, but they have to. Just like those ugly entities had to obey Jesus. And this part will be on, not on the Podomatic podcast, but it'll be on the video podcast, because I thought some things. I wanted to extend that soul thing. You see, even when you made that contract, you did the same thing that just like, say a person sells a piece of property or a home, because your house, your body is a home. It's a home to you. You didn't own the deed to that home. So you couldn't sell it. So that contract is null and void. If you decide it's null and void, you can make that decision with Jesus. I know you want to be famous. I understand that. I wanted to be a rock star. I just didn't want to be. I didn't care about the pain. But boy, I wanted to be a musician. But I had to take the easy road early on. And then in 2006, I started dropping it out there on the internet. And then I dropped my karaoke too, and then Turnbuckle actually gave me a platform that I could actually sing for a couple of years. And I went to other places and probably will in the future when I find them or if I feel like going. I'm pretty sure there's more karaoke in my future. But if not, I did it. And that was sort of like the fantasy of being the rock and roller. And it was good enough for me. And seeing some of my videos would get views, not all of them did, but some of them did. That was enough for me to fulfill the rock star that I wanted to be. And I understand some of y'all want to be that too. And these things, and Satan is preying off of you. They're preying off of you. I'm gonna make this audio version, because I think this part needs to be on the Podomatic too, because it'll have a bigger audience than audio. I'm not gonna drop it on Spreaker, because Spreaker has to be 15 minutes now. And when it goes out, it's got a few more days, but it'll eventually just be 15 minutes. So I think I pretty much said what I needed to say. I prayed what I needed to pray. I'm extending that prayer I prayed all them years ago. When I received those two CDs, and I was watching all these. I mean, even my fighter himself. This is my fighter. He always liked finding bad dudes. He always liked standing up to bad dudes. And he said, I thought I was actually going to see a devil or the Antichrist. And I get there, and he was no different than watching Merle Haggard or any of those people. He said that. And he kicked back. He'd work 3 days straight. When we went to that Marilyn Manson show. 3 days straight with no sleep because his health pulled out on him. He laid back like a baby, and he went to sleep in the Marilyn Manson. And he slept like a baby. And he always told that to people. When they'd start that stuff in about Marilyn Manson, and he'd say, that ain't nothing to him. I felt so comfortable with him, I went to sleep like a baby. That was my fighter. It wasn't an insult to Marilyn Manson, about him going to sleep. He was actually looking forward to seeing him. He wanted to see if he was as bad as they said. Because he was watching it on the evening news just like I was. He was, and we didn't see him to the next, like, a few months later. The next year, actually it was a full year, and nearly probably going on a full year, because we saw him with the alien, the space alien tour. I wanted to see him at the Antichrist tour, but we didn't go to that one. But we did get to see the space alien when John 5 played with him in Atlanta. I even bootlegged that thing. But something happened. I'm going to tell y'all something. Something happened to that tape recorder. When I tried to record it, it didn't turn out too well. But on the B side, anything you record, it was so like as below, so above. That recorder from that day forward till the day it tore up, you recorded anything on the front side, it recorded on the B side backwards. I kid you not. At the Marilyn Manson show. Oh, by the way, we're coming up on this anniversary. And let me pull it up. It's mine. I'm going to pull it up. Hold on just a second. Technical difficulties, y'all, but this one turned backwards on February the 14th, 1997. And it was recorded two or three days. I worked on it for two or three days. The first Marilyn Manson karaoke I ever did. It was the first ever Marilyn Manson karaoke recording I'd ever did. I just had the album a few days indeed. That would be right along with those devils. Maybe I was an entertaining spirits unaware, as one of the pastors I used to listen to talked about himself. Do you know what I mean? I was a young Christian then, still young. You can definitely tell I was thinking that they had him spooky because I was putting demonic sound effects on that. But I always know the first karaoke we ever did, it was Cyclops One. Maybe I can't see nothing at all. Maybe I was singing about myself there, because I was talking about that in this podcast. Maybe I should sing, "He can't see nothing at all. He can't see nothing at all." But on February, I kid you not, I recorded all day that day and the day before. Because this is the first time I was just learning that song. And I fell asleep. Like I tell y'all now, like I do now. I woke up a little bit after midnight, maybe 1 a.m.-ish. And I thought, well, I'm going to go in there and tape and get and listen to it and hear how it plays. Well, I kid you not, I stick it in tape player. It goes backwards. There's all kinds of paranormal activity happening when those devils appeared. So the paranormal and devils are all the same. And now we're going to finally close the podcast. Sorry about that jumble, jibble, jumble there. Where I was trying to find that.